Welcome to our virtual cooking. Hi everybody, how are you doing? Tonight we have a lovely meal for you tonight. Caroline is going to come in a minute. Come on then.
Okay, I'm coming. I'm just checking the cameras. It says it's live, so I guess
yes,
it's working.
It says it's live, and we're live.
Hello everybody. It's great to see you again. Cheers.
Cheers.
My hot water.
Right, tonight we're cooking curry coconut lamb.
Delicious.
Yes, and we're gonna, I have some nice lamb chops, fresh lamb chops I got there. We're gonna use some red peppers, some shallots, and we're gonna use the curry coconut sauce.
Yeah, and we've got some really good news. I'll show everybody. Da 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 da.
Yes, we won a prize in the
curry
show.
Coconut coming out second, and yeah, I know it's one before, but second at the Great Dorset Chili Festival, which, thank you everybody who voted, who might be watching tonight.
Yes.
Lovely. So it got second prize in the best mulled category. So we're cooking with it tonight.
Yeah. So we have lamb, and what we're going to do, we're going to brown the lamb. We're not going to use any flour. We're just going to brown it off with a little bit of oil, because
just to render the fat off.
Because that's what gives it the flavor.
So many of you know, it's the way we cook our dinner. We're cooking our dinner tonight.
Yes.
And you also, most of you know that I don't really eat meat. And it's one of those things where I will just have a little tiny bit of it, just to taste it. But it's not like a big thing for me eating meat anymore. So mainly I'm more or less vegan now, aren't I? Apart from the odd taste when we cook something. So forgive me, I will not be having a great big portion. So, what else are we doing tonight? So, I'm actually going to make a really lovely crispy pineapple salad. And to do that, I've got some fantastic crispy romaine lettuce. So if you just take a few leaves, I've got one, two, three, four, I've got six leaves of romaine lettuce. I'm going to put a little bit of lovely red onion, just about a quarter to a half. That's quite a big one, not too much. Then, of course, the star of the show is the pineapple. I'm going to prepare that and put that in with a little bit of paprika. I'm going to make a dressing with some olive oil and some lemon, nice and healthy, and finish it off, chop some chives to go in with it. So that's going to be delicious. I'm going to start that in a moment. And I've got a lovely machine, actually, that I use for the pineapple. And it actually just, you just screw it down and it pulls all the pineapple out, so I'm going to do that in a moment. How are you getting along?
Yeah, the lamb is coming.
So I'll come and do a close-up for you. Hi guys. Oh, Julia, hello. Looking forward to our pure heat. I know, we failed making it because Bernie's van broke down. That's another story. Right.
Right, so I'm just browning it off. This is what it looks like. So I'm rendering all the fat off, so it makes it quicker to cook. So when I put the curry coconut sauce, turn it on the high heat, I'm going to put the cover on it too.
And what else have we got?
And let it do its thing.
So we've got some lovely potatoes. We're going to fry the potatoes with the thyme.
And butter.
Yeah, some butter. We're doing quite a lot of fat tonight, aren't we?
Yeah, it's a stodgy one.
Here's my lovely pineapple. The salad.
Yeah, we're going to do the...
It's cold here, isn't it? It's freezing cold.
We're going to do the potatoes. I boiled some potatoes, the French potatoes actually. And I'm going to cut them in little cubes. I'm going to put some fresh thyme, some olive oil, and some butter. And the reason why I'm using the butter will make it creamy and wouldn't stick.
It tastes lovely, doesn't it?
Yes.
And the oil stops the butter from burning.
It stops the butter from burning.
Right,
so the thyme will just give a nice flavor. So it's kind of like a French potato thing going on here.
Like Lyonnaise potatoes, my mum.
That's right, Lyonnaise potato. That's the one I was looking for.
My mum, when we had a hotel when I was little, she used to make Lyonnaise potatoes. And when Bernie was talking about it, I said, I know exactly what that is. Mum used to make Lyonnaise potatoes. So I'm just going to take the lettuce. You could just tear it apart, but I'm just going to do a quick few rough chops.
The lamb smells amazing.
Pop that in my bowl. Back to one side. And I don't want too much purple onion in it, too much raw onion. I'm not that keen on too much raw onion actually in anything. But I'm just gonna chop a little bit of this, just gonna give it a little a little bite to marry up well with the pineapple. And this salad is actually really lovely.
Chop the onions now, the shallots.
We're gonna start crying now. But this is a lovely salad to offset any heavy meat dish that you might be doing.
Yeah, tonight the meat, it's a bit stodgy tonight, but
it's because it's so cold outside.
Yeah, and it's a treat really. So this is what you have, like a Sunday roast. You have a Sunday roast every Sunday because that's your little treat. So if you have it every day, you will look as fat as me, but you don't want that.
You shouldn't say that.
Well,
he's been very good. He's been losing weight.
Yes, I broke the rules a few times this week, but you know what I mean.
I think I'm gonna cry.
You're gonna cry?
Just hit my eyes. So there we go.
It's only two onions.
No, a little bit of onion in my salad, and I'm going to do the pineapple.
So we're aiming for a half an hour time as usual. This is hence why I'm browning the lamb. So where it's fresh from the butchers today, hoping that it will cook nice and tender. So what we're gonna do is take the shallots, the peppers, and put them all in there. Then put some stock with some water, and then the coconut curry. And that's it, let it do its thing.
Okay.
Woo, got my eyes now.
So this is amazing, this little pineapple gizmo. So you just push down and screw it in basically.
Yeah.
Takes the core out. The only thing I don't want to do is lose the juice. So when the juice starts to come out, just tip it into the jug because I don't want to lose the juice. Right. There we go. And then what I'm going to do is just to start to unscrew it and pull. There we go. Keep all that lovely juice. There you go, voila. No waste, that's the great thing. Now what I do is I just hold it like that and I'm going to be lazy and just cut around.
Nice.
Like that.
It's a very good gadget, that.
I know, it's amazing, isn't it? But I don't want the bottom bit, so that's kind of stuck up there. Leave that in. And then just chop the pineapple up into nice chunky pieces. With a bit of outside bit on there. Just check that there's no little outside pieces. There shouldn't be. One or two just caught the edge.
It's getting my eyes.
Yeah?
It's not you.
Am I making you cry? I'm sorry. So I'm then going to add the pineapple and then I'll make the dressing. So we've had a busy week, haven't we?
Yes, we have.
We've been to the Great Dorset
Great
Chili
Dorset
Festival.
Yeah, weather was good.
The weather wasn't too bad at all. We had a little bit of rain, but it was an amazing show as always. Fabulous place. And
now that lamb is brown now.
Very relaxing, wasn't it?
So I'm going to put the shallots.
Oh, are you going to show it to them first? Hang on. I'll just show you how brown it is, what it looks like. Because you definitely want it to...
Yeah, brown it off.
Bring it over a bit.
I brown them off.
Yeah, brilliant. You just want to see... See that? So I just wobble you back again.
I'm going to put the peppers in there. So where the lamb has its own juice, and I hope the onions and the peppers, they contain water. So if I leave them for another 2 minutes to sweat on a high heat, so when I put the stock and I put the curry sauce, then all we have to do is let it simmer.
So now I'm just going to add in these chopped chives. Just a matter of adding in what you want, really, the amount that you want. Now I'm going to make the dressing. So I take one lemon, cut that, a little bit of paprika. Now I've already got that tiny bit of juice from the pineapple in there. I'm going to add in about a quarter of a teaspoon of paprika. Put that in. I use this lovely gizmo here. Use the lemon squeezer. Put my hands around it. This is great. Just squeeze this in. I'm actually going to use the whole lemon. Depends on, I mean, I like lemon in salads. Depends on how much you like. If you don't like it so much, then just use half the lemon. Equally so, you can use lime, which is lovely. Yeah, so we were saying how busy we've been, right?
Yeah, so, sorry, cousin Sean, I'm going to put the stock now in a little bit of water, sorry. We have half a cup of water. I'm just going to put the stock. Not too much. And we're going to put the coconut last of all. Let it do its thing.
So that goes in. Now, a lot of you have said when you've asked us about the coconut curry whether you need to put any type of moisture with it, and we always say use either some stock, some coconut water or coconut cream. If you're using it in a slow cooker, you probably won't need anything because the vegetables and the meat and everything let out its juices. If you're fast, what I call fast cooking on the stovetop, then like we're doing today, you're going to need something. Okay, so I've got my lemon paprika mix here. I'm going to put a splash of olive oil in there. Give this a bit of a mix up. And then add a little bit of salt. About half a teaspoon of salt gone in there. That's nice. Some Cornish sea salt, organic sea salt. We use that actually in our products as well. Yeah. This nice, lovely Cornish sea salt.
It smells lovely. I'm not really a salad person, but
he loves my
when
fruit
Caroline
salads.
Made salads, I do eat it.
You love the fruit salads, don't you?
Yes.
Now, normally I put the salad dressing on at the end. We're going to be ready fairly soon, aren't we? And actually, I quite like, because it's got the pineapple, I quite like to actually soak everything together. So, I'm just going to...
Right, so we're 14 minutes in already.
I'm just going to taste it a little bit.
Right, so now I'm going to put the...
Right, it's a little bit more salt.
Curry coconut. I'm going to put 2 big tablespoons in there. The jar does 4 for 4 people.
Just put a bit more salt in. And I'm just going to put a pinch more paprika in. Just make it a little bit stronger. Just taste as you go, so you get the right taste levels that you want. So I'm going to pour that on and let that just soak in. Good. Give that a little bit of a mix. There, and just let that soak in. Nice tropical crispy salad with pineapple. Good, so that's ready.
Mm.
How are you doing?
Yeah.
So we were trying to talk about our news, weren't we? So the main things is this weekend is Great Dean. Oh, I'm not talking Great Dean. West Dean. We had Great Dorset last weekend, and it's West Dean starting on Friday in Chichester, the most fantastic, beautiful, stately home and gardens. So it's well worth, you know, coming down to visit if you can. So it's Friday, Saturday and Sunday, and we'll be there. So hopefully we'll see some of you too. So, Chef.
Yes, so I put half the jar. What I'm going to put is just put a tad bit more water.
Yeah, you just got to feel it as you go along, and sometimes you have to add a little bit more, don't you? So that's not going to take much longer to cook, is it?
No.
So do you want me to get your potatoes ready?
Start chopping them, yeah.
Right, so next of all, we have our potatoes.
Right, so now with all that's in, I'm just going to let it do its thing.
Now these are already pre-cooked. I've only cooked them earlier, so it's quite a good thing if you have some cooked, you can just put them in the fridge when they're cool, leave them overnight and cook them the next night. About that size?
Yeah, that's fine. And there we put some butter. What do you call that? Do you call that a knob or what do you do?
It's
yesterday?
A pat of butter,
a
isn't
pat
it?
Of butter, okay.
It's about a couple of ounces,
okay.
Isn't it?
And then we put some olive oil. Where's the chopping board?
Yeah.
Now I'm gonna take out the time of the pan.
Okay, so you put the time in at the beginning, do you?
Yeah, because I want the time to cook with the potatoes and everything.
Okay.
Because that's what gives it, that was infused the oil and the butter.
Time,
or
is it?
You could just put the thyme in the branches like this, makes it look more.
And take it out afterwards.
And take it out afterwards.
Thyme is really used extensively in the Caribbean, isn't it?
Yep. It's the number one herb you get on the window ledge in the kitchen.
It's like
and,
everything has
spring
it.
Spring onions.
Yeah.
Rosemary. Yeah, so that's what you do. We just have the thyme with the butter and the oil.
So, do they call, in the Caribbean, spring onions, do they call those scallions, or do they call these scallions?
I don't know, we call them til oignon.
Ah.
That's the only
right.
Small onions.
Small onions.
Yes.
So, that's enough for both of us.
Yes.
So that's about 300 grams of potatoes. So if you, as I say, you can cook them the night before, so chop them up. These were cooked this afternoon, and then you can just finish them off in the pan. Yeah, ready?
Not yet.
Ah. Now the other news we've got, and we did mention it last week, but on the 23rd of September, we've now launched our chili show.
Yes, we have our own chili show.
Which is at Fleet, and the lovely Jennifer Atherton is actually running it for us.
Yeah, go on.
Obviously, I didn't do enough. So, Jenny is actually running it for us. We're sort of doing it together. Jenny's got her own events marketing company, Fuse Projects. So, she's going to be doing all the sort of organisation, and we're just helping on the sides. But it's going to be from 10 o'clock to 5 o'clock, and you can check it out. We'll put a link on there later, won't we?
Yes, we will.
We'll upload it tomorrow, and you can actually see it on our Facebook page as well. So it's Fleet Chili Fiesta.
Fleet Chili Fiesta, yeah.
So we're looking
it's
forward to that.
It's going to be a
that.
Fun day.
It is.
Fingers crossed it's going to be a beautiful sunny day.
Always is in September, isn't it? So if you fancy coming along, or if you even fancy volunteering, we're looking for volunteers as well. And we're looking for serving staff as well on our food store, because we're going to be doing our sauces, we're going to be doing food.
You're going to be doing the food, yeah.
Yeah, and there's going to be about 60
other.
Yeah,
doing some curry goat, jerk chicken, but we're going to use the sauces with it, so you can try it.
And who else is going? We've got a whole bunch of people going, haven't we? And, of course, the chili con carne cook-off.
That's right, and
the finals.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
So we're having a chili con carne cook-off, it's the finals. So that's going to be very exciting too. So there's going to be loads.
And the chili eating competition.
Oh yeah, there's the chili. And that's going to be fun.
Yeah, man.
And it's children friendly as well, so there's some things for the children to do as well. So yeah, come along and join in. Right, we're ready for the potatoes, Chef.
Let me try down here, hang on.
One thing that perhaps we didn't say at the beginning was the sort of lamb. It's actually lamb chops, so they cook really fast. Because normally if you're going to do a lamb curry, you'd have it cooking for hours, wouldn't you? But you know, our video is all about fast cooking. So
this is why I brown it off with the oil, so it already gives the meat a nice little shot. Because it normally takes 15 minutes for that lamb to cook if you're going to fry it.
Yeah.
So.
Right, so if I get our plates now ready.
Okay, cool. I'm going to put the butter on now.
And the lamb will just, that curry will continue to sort of cook, won't it, in its
yeah.
own juices. So, I wonder who's been cooking some of our recipes and yeah, so I don't know. Some, we get pictures from people showing us what they've been cooking, which is really lovely. So do that.
Yeah.
Keep them coming, guys. Keep them coming.
I'm going to put a little pinch of salt.
So these are going to do really hot, really fast, aren't
really
they?
Hot, really fast.
So let me get a close up for you. So how much herbs are you going to use?
Huh?
How many herbs? How much herbs are you going to use in these? What's that?
That's the amount I took.
Ah, okay. So have a look, guys. Okay. So you're going to get it really hot?
Really hot. So I'm going to kind of fry the potatoes because that's a non-stick pan. So I want the...
Put them in. Yum.
Yeah. Good, hey, crackling.
That's the ticket. So how long will they take to fry off?
I'll say about 5 minutes, 5-6 minutes.
Okay.
Because I have it on cool.
Yeah, they're really hot too, those
yeah.
Induction cookers. Okay.
And this is a non-stick, so it will crisp the potato quickly.
Okay, just bringing you back here. Wobbling you around. There we go.
Yeah, it's one of those meals you're going to have when it's a rainy day or it's cold in the winter. You want something to warm you up and to fill you as well. Yeah, this is a great one.
So, when you were back in St. Lucia, did you do a lot of lamb there, or was it mainly goat?
Mainly goat.
Yeah?
Goat and lamb, we would eat it more Christmas time. That was our Christmas.
Okay.
So anybody wants to get either half a goat or a cow, you know, meat. It's Christmas, rum and meat. That's the whole thing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I wouldn't do very well.
You get your priorities right. You get your rum, you stop your rum, then you get your meat, you get your food, and that's all you need.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you go from house to house, and you drink everybody alcohol.
I remember when I was there one Christmas, I didn't do any of that.
No.
I was boring, I just stayed on the beach all day. I tell you what, it'd be nice, wouldn't it, think about going on the beach at Christmas.
Yeah.
Have to sell a lot of sauce to do that.
So I'm going to take all the pips.
Okay, so what did you do? Did you take some of the stalks out?
Yeah, I'm taking some of them out.
So they're nearly ready?
Yeah.
Brilliant. So it's a fast meal. So with us, it's always about quick cooking. You might have noticed.
The whole idea is you order a takeaway. By the time you order, they take your order.
You could have cooked your own
and
dinner.
By the time it comes to you, it's the same here.
You could have cooked your own meal, couldn't you?
Yeah.
So I'm just going to taste a little bit of the salad. Do you want to taste a little bit?
In a sec.
See if the dressing's okay. Yeah. You've got to taste it first.
Nice.
So just giving it a few minutes there to just infuse the the salad, the lettuce and everything, just gives it kind of deeper taste than if you just throw it on and serve it straight away. But normally, if you've got dark green leaves and delicate things, don't put the dressing on because it will wilt it. But with this type of salad with crispy leaves, it works okay. Well, I think it does anyway. Right.
Oh, just put the lamb back on to give it a quick notch up. If you can get the camera and show the guys what it looks like.
Oh, okay. It looks pretty good to my hungry tummy. Right, here we go.
So there you go, guys. That's the potato.
Easy.
Yeah.
And herby. So did you put any salt in those?
Just a little sprinkle. I put a little bit of salt when I cook with me.
Okay.
Yeah. Six minutes and the meal is done.
Fabulous. Brilliant. And remember, if you want our recipe books, if you've joined our newsletter list, you'll get all of our recipe books. You'll get one to start with, our barbecue recipe book, which is absolutely great. If you want to hold a Caribbean barbecue for your friends, just join our newsletter, download the Caribbean Barbecue book. It's got 14 recipes in from start to finish, so you can make the local juice right up to the banana ketchup dessert, and then you'll be able to say, look at me, I've done all this. It was so easy, I've made you a Caribbean barbecue. So the whole thing's in there. And then also we've got our tropical recipe book, which if you haven't got that already, you'll get a link for that every time we send out a newsletter. We just pop a link in so that you can download that as well. So, I'm going to serve some salad.
Yeah. Right. So dinner is ready.
So I'll put your salad on. So I give Bernie a little bit of salad. He gives me a tiny, tiny, weensy bit of meat just to try it so I can talk about it. And I have loads of salad. That's the way it works, doesn't it? That's great, thanks.
So there you go, guys.
You like my fruity salads, don't you, though?
Yeah, they're amazing.
Right.
That's enough salad, thank you very much.
They're amazing. That's enough. Thank you very much.
Well, I have more lamb to myself, so. Give you some more gravy. Show them what the meal looks like, camera.
I will, and you can say cheerio.
So, there you go, guys. Again, 28 minutes, and we have a lovely meal.
There we go.
And there it is.
And I think it's kind of surprising that you can make a meal like that fast. I don't think people always realise how fast you can make a meal.
It's all about the fresh cuts of meat as well.
And the right cuts of meat.
Yeah, and the right cuts.
Because if you had stewing lamb, obviously you couldn't make it like that. Okay, so
let's try.
We better try. I'm gonna try a potato.
Mm.
I love potatoes done like this.
Mmm.
Mmm. That's so good. Don't eat the bones.
Lamb is tender on the potato.
So thank you guys for joining us again.
Amazing.
We'll see some of you at West Dean this weekend.
Yes, we will.
Remember, if you go onto our blog, which we've been fiddling around a little bit with, it looks we're putting some extra links in and things, so you can get all sorts of news and recipes on there, and it's all good.
Yes, yes. So thank you guys once again, and I will enjoy this meal.
We'll see you next week, and we hope you enjoy your dinner too. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.